Questions like, is a daughter a coparcener, or whether she is entitled to inherit the properties of her parents, leads to what are the property rights of a woman in India, especially a daughter. In this video, you will understand the inheritance rights of a daughter in relation to properties of her parents. Namaskar friends, welcome again to Legal Mind Education Series. I am your friend Ajit Kumar, advocate and mediator. The people of India gave themselves the constitution, which says, we the people of India. And India being a democratic country, equality before law is a fundamental right to its citizen. However, matters relating to marriage, divorce, and property settlement, there are different laws for different religion. These are called personal laws. There are two school of thoughts in Hindu law. One is Dayabhaga and the second is Mitakshara law. And a vast majority of India is governed by Mitakshara law. The law of inheritance was codified in Hindu Succession Act 1956, which gave right of inheritance in ancestral property only to coparceners and excluding daughters. A coparcener is a group of male lineal descendants of four generations, and therefore females had no right of inheritance under the provisions of Hindu Succession Act 1956. The inheritance of a property could be by two modes. One is interstate succession, which is when a person dies without executing a will, or by testamentary succession, which is executing a will. Till 2005, women stood to lose on account of being daughters, as they have no right of inheritance in the ancestral properties. In any society, struggle for gender equality is a final goal for social development. In this regard, the Honorable Supreme Court passed a judgment in September 2005 which granted equal right of inheritance to the woman as at par with the male counterparts. This judgment further led to passing of a new act, which is Hindu Succession Amendment Act 2005. This act finally ended the gender discrimination in inheritance law, which was against the woman. This act gave equivalent right to the woman at par with the males in relation to properties. The salient features of this act are that the Hindu daughters have equal right to share and inherit the state of the father as sons. The daughters have also equal right to share in the property of the mothers. In context of coparcener, the daughters have equal right to inherit the ancestral property equivalent to the share of the son. The daughters are also liable to and responsible to the liability over the properties. Further, the married daughters are not entitled for maintenance or for shelter on the parents, except deserted widow or divorced daughter are entitled for right of residence. However, in Muslim law, a Muslim daughter is entitled to inherit a share which is equal to one half of the son's share in their father's state, which means she only gets half to what a son's get. A Muslim daughter has a full control on her share of the property, with all rights to control, manage and dispose of the property as she wishes during her lifetime or after her death. A Muslim daughter receiving gifts in her marriage do not dilute her right to inherit the share from her parents' estate. An unmarried daughter is entitled for maintenance and parental support. A divorced daughter in Muslim law with child, if they are minors, or without child, is entitled for maintenance after a death period. Seeing both the provisions and the rights of inheritance in Hindu and Muslim law, it is apparent that in Muslim law there is still a gender discrimination in relation to inheritance of the property. Thanks a lot for watching. Please like and share this video. You can also subscribe my channel by clicking here. Thanks a lot.